Hey guys, it's Mrs. Kleinley with this week's First Chapter Fridays. This week, I'm excited to be talking to you about Spy School by Stewart Gibbs. This name might look familiar to you because we had a previous First Chapter Friday called Space Case by Stewart Gibbs. So same author, different series. This is the first book in the Spy School series. I do not feel strongly, some series you really need to read in order. This one, I do not think you need to read in order. However, you should start with Spy School as the first book because it kind of helps build the background knowledge and understand the scenario and the situation and, you know, who these characters are and all of that. So I would definitely start with Spy School. And then after that, I don't really think it matters what order you read them in. So this is a book about a kid named Ben who ends up getting recruited to go to Spy School, which is essentially like the elementary middle school for the CIA. It's like a feeder program to become a spy for United States of America. And this kid, like, he didn't even apply to be in Spy School. He kind of got recruited. And it's something he always wanted to do. But he was very surprised to come home from school and find the CIA recruiter in his house. So that's where chapter one actually starts us off with. And it's, I'll jump right into it. Chapter one, recruitment. And it says Ripley Residence, 2107 Mockingbird Road, Vienna, Virginia, January 16th, 1500 hours. Hello, Ben, said the man in my living room. My name is Alexander Hale. I work for the CIA. And just like that, my life became interesting. It hadn't been up until then, not by a long shot. That day had been a prime example, day 4583, 7 months into the 12th year of my mundane existence. I had dragged myself out of bed, eaten breakfast, gone to middle school, been boarding class, stared at girls. I was too embarrassed to approach, had lunch, slogged through gym, fallen asleep in math, been harassed by Dirk the Jerk, taken the bus home, and found a man in a tuxedo sitting on the couch. I didn't doubt he was a spy for a second. Alexander Hale looked exactly like I'd always imagined a spy would look. A tiny bit older, perhaps. He seemed about 50, but still suave and debonair. He had a small scar on his chin, from a bullet, I guessed, or maybe something more exotic, like a crossbow. There was something very James Bond about him. I could imagine he'd been in a car chase on the way over and taken out the bad guys without breaking a sweat. My parents weren't home. They never were when I got back from school. Alexander had obviously let himself in. The photo album from our family vacation to Virginia Beach sat open on the coffee table before him. Am I in trouble? I asked. Alexander laughed. For what? You've never done anything wrong in your life, unless you count the time you spiked Dirk Dent's Pepsi with X-Lax, and frankly, that kid was kind of asking for it. My eyes widened in surprise. How did you know that? I am a spy. It's my job to know things. Do you have anything to drink? Sure. My mind quickly cataloged every beverage in the house. Although I had no idea what this man was doing there, I found myself desperately wanting to impress him. My folks have all kinds of stuff. Would you like a martini? Alexander laughed again. This isn't the movie, kid. I'm on the clock. I blushed, feeling foolish. Oh, right. Water? I was thinking of something more like an energy drink, something with electrolytes, just in case I need to leap into action. I had to ditch some undesirables on my way over here. Undesirables? I tried to sound cool, as though I discussed things like this every day. What sort of... I'm afraid that information is classified. Of course. That makes sense. Gatorade? That'd be grand. I headed to the kitchen. Alexander followed. The agency has had its eye on you for some time, he said. I paused, surprised, the refrigerator door half open. Why? For starters, you asked us to. I did? When? How many times have you accessed our website? I grimaced, feeling foolish once again. 728. Alexander looked at the tiniest bit intrigued. That's exactly right. Usually you merely play the games on the kids page, at which you perform very well, by the way, but you've also browsed the employment and internship pages with some regularity. Ergo, you've considered a career as a spy. And when you express an interest in the CIA, the CIA becomes interested in you. Alexander pulled a thick envelope from inside his tuxedo and set it on the kitchen counter. We've been impressed. So I'm going to stop there. But from that point, he's swooped off to CIA school, to spy school. His parents think he got accepted to a science academy. It's super, super top secret that he's at this spy school. And all kinds of adventure and mystery and suspense comes your way when you read Spy School by Stewart Gibbs. This book can be found in our adventure section.